keep his thumb jammed in a dam that holds his dreams. But that's a secret only Margaret knows. In Amsterdam is golden, in the morning Margaret brings him breakfast. Tulips bloom beneath the snow. He's mad as he can be, but Margaret only sees that sometimes she sees her unborn child in his eyes. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the water above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. The Dutchman still wears wooden shoes, his coat and cap are patched with the love that was. He watches tugboats down canals and calls out to them when he thinks he knows the captain. Till Margaret comes to take him home again through unforgiving streets that trip him though she holds his arm. Go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. Her in, she wraps his muffler tighter, they sit in the kitchen. Some tea with whiskey keeps away the dew. He sees her for a moment, calls her name, she makes his bed up, humming song. Together in the night, the Dutchman falls asleep and Margaret blows the candle. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago I used to be a young man,
I want to talk about a cute story in Yankee Stadium.
Well, it was very cute.
It had a happy ending. It had a happy ending
yes.
at the end.
September 14th, 1985. I was invited to sing the Star Spangled Banner originally, and a few days before that date, I was advised that I was to sing O Canada as well. It was a playoff game with the Blue Jays and the Yankees, and I know it's very good to be, you know, a certain degree, a certain amount of nervousness gets you, keeps your adrenaline going. But apparently I was over nervous, and when I was, and I was practicing in the dugout with Billy Martin, it was fine. And when I had to walk out to home plate, does anyone know how long home plate is when there's 70,000 people in the stands, Bronx bombers in the stands? And I knew I went blank, but I thought for sure, as soon as I opened my mouth, you know, it would come out. And O Canada came out, and that was all. And I said, I'm very sorry. I have the words back in the dugout. I walked back to the dugout and then back to home plate. First, the fans were booing. Then they were kind of laughing. And then they were going. It was so pathetic because, oh, I was so nervous. In this, I'm very nearsighted, blind is a better word. And the paper was shaking like this. I couldn't see the words anyway. And with the little delay that occurs in stadiums, I made up a new melody, never mind forgetting the words. At that stage, the whole stadium was, come on, Mary, you can do
They're
it.
They're rooting for you.
You
now.
Can do it. Needless to say, the Canadians weren't pleased. It was George Steinbrenner was not pleased. The Yankees lost the game that night and 7 more to follow. And it was still in the papers 4 days later, I mean, in the New York Times. And I finally said, "This people are starving in Ethiopia. I'm hiding out on the beach because I really, totally, I was devastated. I was absolutely devastated that this could possibly happen. And as I was walking out, I just kept walking, you know. I sang the Star Spangled Banner probably as fast, it must have sounded like the Chipmunks, just to get awake out of that place. And Mr. Pellegrino, what a lovely, lovely man, the PR man for the Yankees, said, but Mary, you know, Robert Merrill's forgotten it, Willie Nelson, Aretha Franklin, you're not the only one. I said, but I'm just little Mary O'Dowd. I had to go back to sing at Jimmy Walker's where I'd performed for the last 4 years, and they had hired extra televisions. The place was packed to the gills. And you can't cry, because you know, Eddie, if you're singing and you cry, I mean, you can't start crying. I had to go on and do the next show. And.
But you got the publicity. Oh, they probably thought it was a
publicity. Well, what happened? Well, you know, maybe they did. Because finally, when I read this, 4 days later, in the Times, I called the Canadian consulate, and then I said, I need Mayor Eggleton's address. I mean, do you understand that nobody, your whole country put together, cannot possibly feel as badly as I feel? I'm the one that did it. And so they said, well, call him. Call him. So I called him, and the secretary answers, and I said, this is Mary O'Dowd. But just 1 second, put me right through, and I apologized and explained that I would never be disrespectful to a country, and my mother and father from Ireland, and I'm a good American, and oh, forget it. He said, you sound like a nice person. Would you go on satellite TV tonight for 6 o'clock?
See?
So I did, and I apologized to all the Canadians, and the next day, airline ticket came. They flew me up to Canada to sing O Canada to make sure that I really knew it. And I had bodyguards. Now, I said, who are these people following me? And they were so angry up there. Because you see, apparently a lot of people have been messing up the Canadian National Anthem. And it wasn't just me. It was just that I was the one that was it.
Right.
And they said, Mary, these are your bodyguards because a lot of people are a little upset with you. So there was this press party and the Blue Jays, and it was really very, very much fun because the people that met were delightful, and I sang O Canada for everybody, and I sang it very well, and I didn't forget any of the words, thank you, God. And the headlines the next day were, Canadians love Mary O. So turned out fine.
And you ended up becoming very well known in the United States.
Well, I'm in the Blooper Hall of Fame. I got to sing, there's some people that are really putting a sincere endeavor together of a New York Sports Museum and Hall of Fame, which is going to probably really happen. And I was invited to sing the national anthem because, and of course, not because I'm in the Hall of Fame, but I'm in the Blooper Hall of Fame. So they thought it'd be appropriate that somebody that has attempted the anthems before should get one more try. So I sang last Monday night, and that was fun. And then everybody went over to Runyon's afterwards to have a little party. And I sang with all the Rangers and the Islanders, and it was great. So
triumphant comeback.
We see. That's what's fun about being an Irish singer. We can always laugh at ourselves.